Welcome to Medicare 2017. This is the kickoff event, so we're going to go through the changes and the things that are going to be happening for this next year. For those that don't know me, I'm Jeff Wetzel, president of Bridalwood Insurance. Thank you all for coming out. You probably read this little newsletter called Bridalwood News. Anybody see that? Terrific. Well, thank you for reading it. I write it, you read it, I appreciate it. Probably have a couple things in your desk. One of them looks like this 2017 checklist. We're going to kind of go through that at the end. The other thing that's happening is this Saturday, I don't know if anybody's been watching the paper, they have this aging expo going on down in San Diego. Anybody seen that?
Yes.
So anyway, they got me, they called and said, can you come in and talk about something? It's like, well, what are we doing? So I wanted to do was go over common mistakes that Medicare people make, and we want to avoid some of the common mistakes. So with your permission, I'm going to practice on you guys because I got 500 people I got to do it in front of at noon on Saturday, okay? Fair enough? All right. So, yeah, no problem. Come on in. We've been waiting for you. Now you're here. Now we can get started. How many people think of Medicare and see a picture like this? Confusing. Part D drug plan, Part A, C, D, how's all that stuff work together, right? It's like a big puzzle. Well, today we're going to kind of make it a little bit easier, hopefully. So we get done here, you're going to go out and go, oh, so that's how it works. Oh, so that's all that's involved. All right, we can do that. So a little bit of background. How many were born during this period of time? 1946 to 1964. 77 million babies were born in this country. Everybody knows the baby boomers, right? Well, what you didn't know is a couple things that are coming. We're year five of the 18-year cycle of you guys turning 65. That means we've got the next 13 years of all you guys are just going to keep on coming every day. All right? Today, there are 56 million people, Americans, on Medicare right now. 56 million. There are 10,000 baby boomers turning 65 every day. This will continue to the year 2030. In the year 2030, 80 million people will be on Medicare. Strange wonder that they predict Medicare to go bankrupt in 2028. So if you're born in 62 to 64,
you're out of luck.
You're out of luck. You might have to swim for it. So your Medicare card that you got looks a lot like this. It's pretty simple. It was Part A and Part B. Your name, your Social Security number on it. I don't know what genius thought that up, but the government puts your Social Security number on your Medicare card and passes out in the mail, but you're supposed to carry around. So they finally figured it out, and they're going to change it this next year. They're going to put random numbers on there. But that's still coming. So a little trivia question. Who was the very first Medicare, you guys know all this. Who was the very first Medicare recipient, got the first card in this country? Harry Truman. Harry Truman was the very first one. Who was the second? His wife, Bess. Who was the third? I don't know the third. I was hoping you guys would know. All right. Page one of our little book that we have in front of us here is the first common mistake is not enrolling in the right time. Not enrolling right time. So when you turn 65, you have 3 months prior to the month of your birthday, and you have 3 months after. But here's a very common mistake. And let's take a look at it. So you can read this over, but let's go on and look at it. We have a kind of a general rule when you're on Medicare. And the general rule is turning 65 or stop working, whatever comes later. So if you're continuing to work, you're covered under your group insurance, it's fine. You don't need to sign up for your Medicare. So let's do a little case study of somebody that's turning 65. This gentleman here, Stan, is turning 65. His wife is 62. Very common. Stan wants to work another 3 years till his wife also qualifies for Medicare. So he's covered under his group insurance, but Stan's worried about getting a late enrollment penalty. So he goes ahead and signs on to his Medicare, even though he's covered under group insurance. So he's actually paying two fees. So did Stan do the right thing? No. Because Stan is still working under his group insurance, he does not need to turn his Part B coverage on. So if we took Stan, said he was charged $121 a month, and we went 3 years, that equals a $4,384 loss that he didn't need to take. So that's kind of a common mistake that people make getting on Medicare. They got this so ingrained that you're going to make a mistake and you have a penalty the rest of your life, but you kind of need to check with somebody, Bridalwood, to make sure that you really don't need to sign up, or you do need to sign up so that you don't make a $4,000 mistake. All right, let's go on to number two, not analyzing your drug coverage. Anybody here take prescription drug medicine? Be a better question, who doesn't, right? One, you got one, two, yeah. So what happens is, many times, is you get into Medicare season, and I see this all the time, and it drives me crazy, okay? They get this spreadsheet of all the plans in the area, and they take the spreadsheet, and they go, well, it's $5 to the doctor and $10 to a specialist, or it's $10. So they look by price, but they don't look beyond the cover to find out what other things you should be aware of, like drug coverage. It's important because everybody's formulary is a little bit different. Question, how many different Part D drug plans are there in San Diego alone?
A lot.
25. 25 different drug plans. Every one of them are different. We have to know them. You don't, but we have to know them. Point is, let's look at another case. Case study. Sylvia is choosing her Advantage plan for the new year. And she found a plan that her doctor is $5 less than a competing plan. So instead of, didn't realize, she got on the plan, it was $5 cheaper to the doctor, she's saving money, till the first month she goes to fill her prescriptions, and instead of her normal $47 a month, now it's $100 a month. That's the difference between a tier 3 level medicine and a tier 4 level medicine. So she didn't realize that, guess what? You're stuck because you can't change it till the next open enrollment, which is 12 months away. So for that whole year, she had to pay the extra money for a tier 4 level medicine when her other plan, the one that was $5 more, she would have got her prescriptions at a much less lower price. Cost to Sylvia is $1,272 for the year. Here's the best part. Remember that $5 she was saving? She'd have to go to her doctor 254 times to make up for it. All right. Don't always look at the price because there's other things to consider. All right. Number three, knowing the difference between an Advantage plan and a supplement plan. How many people know the difference between an Advantage plan and a supplement plan? This is mission critical. If you learn nothing else today, know the difference between an Advantage plan and a supplement plan. They are two different animals working two different directions. We're going to cover it right now. Remember that original Medicare we talked about that Harry Truman started back in 1965? Here's a trivia question. What date was it that they signed Medicare into law in 1965? July 30th, 1965. I don't know why I know that. Okay, back in 65, they started Part A and Part B. That's your original Medicare. To keep things simple, original Medicare covers 80%. What you and I do is the other 20%. You say, well, 80% is pretty good. But guess what? You get sick, these doctors can run up a $100,000 bill in the blink of an eye, and there probably isn't anybody here who could write a check for 20 grand and not have it hurt a little bit. So you need something to plug the holes, that other 20%. That's where you come down to option one, option two. Option one and option two, the biggest difference is who's in charge of your health care? Option one leaves Medicare in charge of your health care. Because Medicare is a nationwide program, you can go to any doctor, any specialist, any hospital, anywhere in the country. What Medicare doesn't pay for, your supplement plan on option one will pick that up. All right. So your option one allows you to go to any doctor, any specialist, any hospital. Downside is expensive. It's expensive going that direction. Expensive to have that supplement plan. We go option one, we have to buy our Part D drug plan separately. Now we have three payments. We have our Medicare payment. Usually comes out of Social Security check. How many people have their Social Security check, take their payment out? Then we have a supplement plan payment. Then we have a Part D drug plan payment. Three payments every month. Option two is what many of you are on in this room. Option two is called an Advantage plan, also known as an HMO plan. The biggest difference is Medicare is no longer in control of your health care. Medicare transfers primary insurance to the insurance company, whether it's United Healthcare, Humana, Kaiser, SCAN. They're now in charge of your health care. It's not a bad thing. It's just that the healthcare company, the insurance company, receives a check from Medicare every month to take care of you. So that means is they come by and they see Penny Carlson. Penny Carlson is one of my fabulous agents at Bridalwood, one of the best agents in San Diego. Look at Penny, picture of health. Works out every day. Eats like a rabbit every day. Terrific, right? Then you got Ed Perry. Ed Perry, I want you, Ed, stand up for a minute. Ed Perry.
I'm not quite as
healthy. Look at poor Ed. Poor Ed. Poor Ed's been hanging out at McDonald's for the last 20 years. Runs a open heart bypass surgery, runs a $500,000 bill up at Medicare, right? They're not going to pay it. The insurance company has to pay it. They make money in Penny, they lose money in Ed, and it's a business, and that's how they do it. So your option two is a package deal. That's what they call a C plan. There's four parts of Medicare, A, B, C, and D. A and B is your original Medicare. Your part C, for combined, combines your A, B, C, and D all in one package. Many times the price is zero. Think of it as pay-as-you-go insurance. It costs you nothing monthly, it's just when you use the services, when you go to your primary doctor, you pay a copay. You go to your specialist, you pay a copay. With that, your Part D drug plan is included. As we go through today's presentation, and we start breaking down the individual plans, you'll need to know, everybody knows what plan they're on, right? There's always one in every group. Always one. Okay, so we know the difference between an Advantage plan and a supplement plan. Little test here. Who's in charge of your health care in option one? Medicare. Medicare's primary insurance. Option two, the insurance company is your primary insurance. Okay, see how sharp you guys are. What major medical group in San Diego does not accept Medicare?
Kaiser.
Kaiser. You're sharp. You're two in a row now. Kaiser. Kaiser does not accept Medicare. You can go to any doctor, any specialist, any hospital in the country, except Kaiser. You have to be on a Kaiser plan. Kaiser's over here. They're an option two. And to go on to Kaiser, you have to assign your insurance, your primary care, Medicare, over to Kaiser. And then they get paid from Medicare, and they take care of your health care. But they don't share it with anybody else. They're called a closed network, a closed system. What I worry about that is if you get sick, something happens, you better hope they have the best doctors at Kaiser because you can't go anywhere else. If you read the newsletter, it's I put it in, you're stuck. All right, let's go. We talked option two. not evaluating your retiree options. Number four. So this is a good one. A lot of times we come by this. You've worked 30, 40 years for your group coverage, and you don't want to give it up. I mean, I've spent my life so I can have this group coverage, but it's expensive. But it's worth it because it's my group coverage, and my company's been taking care of me for 40 years. Well, many times that's not the case. Many times, these group coverage plans, they've been pushing more and more of the cost onto you. And that price keeps going higher. And sometimes we can sit down and take a look and go, wait a minute. You could actually be on Medicare, be a much better plan and a lower price plan and give you actually better benefits than being on your group insurance that you have now. So that's one way. Second way though is, and you're evaluating your retiree options, is does everybody know that the price that you pay for your Part B in Medicare, that part that comes out of your Social Security check, is determined from what you made 2 years back. So right now, 2016, you're looking at 2014 income. So if you next year, 2017, they're looking at 2015 income, adjusted gross income. So what's a common mistake that happens, little case study here, Bill and Sue are preparing for retirement, and they're age 63. So they cash out some of their company stock options and adds $260,000 on top of their annual income of $170,000 for the two of them. Because Medicare looks back 2 years, they'll each have to pay for their Medicare an extra $340 a month, every month for that. So that just cost them $8,100. So many financial planners think it's a great idea, and it probably is, to take a regular IRA and roll it into a Roth IRA. Probably makes terrific sense to do that. Take stock options, sell property. I'm getting ready to retire. I don't need to work, manage this property. Let's get rid of it. So Wolfgang Kranzl right there, one of the biggest realtors right here in Escondido, Poway. He probably recommends people all the time to sell property, buy property. Do it at age 62. Then when they look back 2 years, you're not going to get soaked for $8,100. All right? Wolfgang, you agree with that? Yeah? Okay. All right. Number five. Selecting your Medicare plan and getting on your different Medicare plans based on your neighbor's advice, your bookie's advice. My goodness. I've heard one story after another. Sign me up and put me on Plan F. Well, why were you doing that? Well, my neighbor did it, so I guess I got to do it too. So, I didn't tell you, my mom came to town. Bless her heart. You know, she's sweet and everything, but we're having breakfast one morning. You know, your breakfast, you got your newspaper and you got your cup of coffee and a little tickle in my throat. I got to cough a little bit. She goes, that sounds bad. You need to go to the doctor right away. And while you're there, I'm going to schedule a colonoscopy for you too. Mom, really, I'm not a doctor, but I kind of think one doesn't have anything to do with the other. So anyway, my point is I don't take medical advice from my mom anymore. So be careful where you get your information from. Because we need to kind of have it, make sure that we're getting things straight. The other thing is that I've learned by doing this for, how many people have been with me from day one? We're going in 8 years, 8 years together. And what I've found is that with all the diversity of the funds that are out there and all the different choices that we have, that going with an agent that only has one product is not probably a real good idea to do. Because guess what he's going to try to sell you? That one product. Remember the gal that got a plan for $5 less, but ended up paying her an extra $1,200 in her medicine? Well, if that agent that only had one product knew that the competing product was better, would save her money, do you think he's going to tell her? No. So you got to be careful where you're getting your information from. So that's why we have expanded as fast as we have just because and make every single agent get qualified with multiple plans across the board, and we drill them and train them until they got the stuff down inside and out. All right? So that's how that works. On the back of the book that you have right here, does everybody have ink pens? We got ink pens out, right? These guys, they're so sharp. Everybody meet my daughter, Madison. If you're calling into the office, give her a good hand, yes. She has to put up with me every single day. That's worth it. Anyway, she kind of took some time off for teaching to help us out this year because our office is getting kind of busy. So I appreciate that she's helping out. My fabulous bride over here, Kimberly, she's another one helping out in the office. Give her a hand. She has to put up with me 24/7. Not that. So on the back of the book that we have, it's a little Bridalwood book. For anybody who wants to get a hold of me or don't have it already, it's my email is jeff@bridalwoodinsurance.com. Real simple. jeff@bridalwoodinsurance.com. So if you need to go a hold of me, send me an email, call me, text message, smoke signals, whatever it takes. I'll get to it. A couple things that change this year, the star ratings. They're all big on star ratings. All these insurance companies have different star ratings. One is terrible and five is terrific. So United Healthcare, your plan has a 4-star rated. And they fund these insurance companies by their star ratings. So for somebody that's got 5 stars gets more money than the 4 stars. Remember that money they send to the insurance company every month? It's all based off the star ratings. The other thing, the summary of benefits. When you guys leave today, we have booklets that were by the door that they're going to get out, because Bill Murray right there, that's Bill Murray. Bill Murray right there is going to get those books ready to go. So anybody that wants their plan that they have for the next year, this is a checklist we're going to go over here in a little bit. We'll go through the checklist and see if you said, oh, I want the sharp plan for next year. We'll make sure you get a sharp booklet as you go out the door today. The last thing is their multi-language interpreter services. They're one of these things, they want me to mention it. So if you've been here for the last half hour and haven't understood a word that I've said, we can get an interpreter and bring him in and he can explain it to you. So anyway, I did my part and I said multi-language interpreter services. So what's new for 2017? What's new, Scooby-Doo? So maybe you've heard, but we have a new Bridalwood kiosk up at the Escondido Mall.
Right on.
Yep. So we're trying to be out there, and Peggy Tomasello in the back of the room standing there, she came up with that terrific idea. I said, let's do it. Sounds good. So that's what we did. We found an artist, a guy that wraps these carts, and I said, I want it to scream Medicare when you walk by it. I think he did a good job.
Right on.
I don't want to say Bridalwood, I want it to scream Medicare. So that's what it is. What happens is we have people there 11 hours every day, Monday to Friday, Monday to Sunday, all through the week. So if you need anything, send somebody down there, whatever you need, we're there for you. Our office isn't open on the weekend, but our kiosk will be. So that's what's new this year. And if you saw, I know some of you have taken advantage of it. In the newsletter this month, there's a little coupon. If you go on down to the kiosk, they'll give you a free scoop of Baskin-Robbins ice cream right there. So there you go. Get a scoop on me. The other thing that the phones have been blowing up is this new over-the-counter drugstore that they're bringing to you for free. It's only for the Sharp plan and the Plan 4. It's the 2-0 premium plans. How many people are on the Sharp plan? There we go. So guess what? You're all going to get this. What it is, you get $200 a year of supplies that you can order free of charge. It's $50 a quarter. $50 a quarter for free. So you go on this little website shopping list. They got a little booklet you can have too if you don't like to go onto the internet. And you just pick out your supplies. You'll take out one of these and one of these. Band-Aids, vitamins, skincare, lotion, anything that you would walk into a drugstore and you could just pick off the shelf, you can order this online. $50 a quarter. If you don't use it, you lose it. So as March 31st, Make sure you spend all your money, because April 1, it starts over again. And so we're going to have to remind you quarterly to spend your money. So I was looking at it. It's kind of a neat little deal. It's an extra $200 of stuff that you can get that, you know, we didn't have before. And it's nice. So, I mean, like I said, it's skincare lotion and Band-Aids and all that good stuff. So that is coming out. Now, we've got the sites, we've got the logins, we have the catalogs, we have all the stuff, but none of this starts until January 1st. So your plan will be January 1st, you can log in and order your stuff. Probably will be in the December newsletter.
It's also a mail catalog.
Also a mail-in catalog. So what'll happen is they'll send you a little catalog like this with an order form, and you can fill your order form out, and you just go down your checklist and take one of these and one of these and one of these. See these little numbers right here? You just fill your numbers in then, tell them what you want, and put in the total, and it's $50 a quarter that they give you. Pretty neat deal, huh? Yeah. So some people out there that go to Scripps, anybody go to Scripps? Go to Scripps, probably we have you on the plan 4 with United, plan 4. And then there's another plan out there that competes with the Scripps. It's called SCAN. Anybody heard of SCAN? Got it. So SCAN competes with also at Scripps. What happens is the SCAN plan is a good plan. We have some people that are on it, have some benefits. They're kind of like the $5 cheaper thing. So if United's $20 or $15, it's kind of like that across the board. But they only get to Scripps. They only go to Scripps. But they don't have this over-the-counter catalog this year. So basically, I'm kind of looking at it. So unless you're beating a path back and forth to the doctor, I think it might make sense to stay on the United Healthcare Plan 4 so that you get this extra $200 benefit that somebody at a SCAN plan would not. Make sense? Yes, you can still go to Scripps. So Plan 4 will get you to Scripps doctors. And whoever your primary doctor is, that's the network you have to choose from.
$69 a month? No, zero.
That's a zero premium plan. And we're going to go through the individual plans a little bit at the end of this, and we'll kind of break it down. You had a quick question? But at the end, we're going to go through in which plan and how much it costs and the benefits, the pros and cons for this next year. So we'll come up to that next. You had a quick question? Good question. Does it roll over? So you get $200 a year, and it's $50 a quarter. And it's use it or lose it. $50. Yep. You got to spend $50 in your quarter. And quarters are January 1 to March 31st and April 1 to June 30th. And there's your quarters, right?
Is that the first one on this?
That is. It's the first one on that comparison sheet that you have right there. It's actually, I believe, the first two plans. Let me look real quick here. Yes, the first two plans are the ones that will be benefit of this over-the-counter. Okay? Yes?
What about the tier 1 and tier 2 being no charge? Is that staying?
You guys are taking my thunder away. I was saving that. That's the grand finale. I was going to give you that. That's the dessert, and we're still in the meat and potatoes. Yes, your answer is yes. 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 So your generics are free in both of those two plans. So we get to that point. For those people that are on the value plan, the $25 a month or the $69 premier plan, we need to talk. Because I don't know if we need to be there any longer, right? So we'll get to that point. Okay. Let's take a look. We have a checklist we're going to go through. Kim? We have a checklist that we're going to go through here. And what I want to do is I want to start with, everybody got this list in front of you there? Let's kind of go through this.
No?
No? We got it at the door? This little list, checklist. They probably gave it to you at the door when they checked in. They said, this is the plan you're on. Anybody doesn't have one, raise their hand, we'll get it out to you. Got one over here? Got it? Okay. Anybody else? Way in the back. Yeah, I'll take a question. Okay, so the question is, you have the scan plan now. Can you go to Sharp with your scan plan?
I like Script. I like Scan.
Got it?
If I go to Sharp, can I still use Script?
If you want to go to Scripts, you'll have to either stay in your scan plan or go to Plan 4. United Healthcare Plan 4 will get you to Scripts. The Sharp plan, we'll go through that second. The Sharp plan is only to Sharp doctors. So let's go ahead and talk about, remember that part about option one, remember the supplement plans? All right, we're gonna talk about the supplement plans. How many people have a supplement plan right now? We got a few. Let's go through it. Supplement plans. Supplement plans clean up what Medicare doesn't pay for. Remember the Medicare pays the A and the B? Remember that? And then whatever A and B doesn't get paid for, they send over the supplement plan and they pick it up. There's really three plans that I'll let you do. One is Plan F. You've heard of Plan F, right? Plan F I like to call Plan Fabulous. I like the Fabulous plan because whatever Medicare doesn't pay for, Plan Fabulous picks up. No co-pays, no deductibles, no anything. Go wherever you want to go. So Plan Fabulous is good. The next one is the N plan, which I like to call the nice plan, the nice plan. The nice plan is less than the fabulous plan. It still lets you go to any doctor, any specials, any hospital. The difference is it's $20 each time you go to the doctor. $20, that's not too bad, right? $20 when you go, but it's much less than the Plan F. For somebody that's age 65, a Plan N, the nice plan, is $600 a year less than Plan F. Do you go to the doctor 40 times a year? Then what are you doing on Plan F? Because it's too much, right? There's a new plan coming out this year. We call Plan G. It's the good plan. The reason that they're doing that is because they made a change to Plan F starting in 2020. Here's the change. The change in 2020 is going to say that anybody that's on Plan F is allowed to stay, anybody turning 65 after January of year 2020, Plan F is not going to be available. And here's why. They want you to put some skin in the game before you go to the doctor. Because Fabulous Plan is so great, you don't pay any co-pays. There's people going to their doctor because they're lonely. They want to talk to their doctor. They got a tickle in their throat. My mom says, go get a colonoscopy. No, no, Mom, we're not going to do that. But they run to the doctor because they have Plan F and it doesn't cost them anything to do that. They're already making their payment. So why should I worry about it? Well, that's what they're going to charge. So Plan G, a Plan G plan is a good plan. And what they're going to do is have you pay a little bit of a deductible up front. And then after you pay that deductible, then it acts like an F plan the rest of the year. Right now, that deductible is $166. So to Plan G, a good plan, you pay the first $166, and then it acts like a Plan F the rest of the year. So when you hear the news about Plan F going away, don't worry. You can stay in it because you've already been awarded it. You probably won't want to, because what happens is they won't let any new people into the plan. So the only ones that are in there are getting older and sicker and more trips to the doctor, and that plan's going to get expensive and expensive, 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 right? So you want to be in a plan where they have fresh people coming in because they can keep the payments and the prices lower. We still got 3 years. So what I'm saying is this Plan G with United Healthcare will be coming out July of next year. So it's coming in July. It isn't available yet, but it's coming. So anybody that has a supplement plan This next year, we'll take a look at it. Right now, I either have you on the fabulous plan or I have you on the nice plan. But we will also look at the good plan, the G plan, starting July of next year. In terms of price, fabulous plan will be the most expensive, the good plan will be the middle, the nice plan will be the lower price plan. United Healthcare is also the only one that lets you switch among the plans anytime during the year, no questions asked. Anybody else, Blue Shield, Humana, Aetna, all these other guys, whatever plan you're in, you're stuck for the year. You have to wait till open enrollment to be able to change. You had a quick question.
All right. This is F, and this is 4. This is N, and this is G.
Terrific. You got it all screwed up. Thank you. All right. So there's nothing on your table that's going to talk about plan F and G and all that stuff, right? All right, so only thing on your table, I just want to confuse you and see if you're paying attention. Only thing on your table is we're talking about is those Advantage plans. The Advantage plan, zero premium plan. We're going to come to that next. But for those that have to have a supplement plan, the typical supplement plan person is one that goes to many doctors, goes to different networks. I have a doctor at Sharp, I have one at Scripps, I have one at UCSD. I go spend 3 months with my kids in Chicago. You probably want a supplement plan because you can go to any doctor, any special, any hospital, except for Kaiser. You can't go to Kaiser. I can't say enough bad things about Kaiser. Actually, I had one of my kids was born at Kaiser and they were terrific. So I can't say that. They were terrific. So now that is over, we're going to go and talk about Plan Fabulous. What's nice about it, no deductibles, no co-pays, any doctor. What's nice about that? Bad side is expensive. Plan Fabulous is a little expensive. So it's also the most complete. It's also the most expensive. If money's no object, then go ahead and knock yourself out. Plan Nice. The Nice plan, $166 deductible. Has a $20 copay every time you go to the doctor, and it's a little bit cheaper than Plan F. And before we go too much farther, you don't have to take a whole lot of notes on this. As you can see, raise your hand, Jorge, right there. He's recording all this. So you guys are going to be fabulously recorded and put on the internet so you guys can see your shiny faces. So anyway, all this will be, you'll be able to go through it again and look at it all over. So if you miss something, don't worry about it. You'll be able to watch it over and over. The Nice plan also has some co-pays and has deductibles. So it's $166 deductible in the Nice plan, and then it's $20 every time you go to the doctor after that. It certainly does. So the first $166 comes out of your pocket, and then after that, it just knocks it out. Yep. So the $20 is only when you go to the doctor. If you end up at the hospital, it's 100% paid for in the Nice plan. Yep. So that's the nice thing about supplements. It gives you the freedom of being able to go, but it's expensive, and you're paying that whether you go to the doctor every month, the supplement plan. But it gives you the freedom of where you want to go. Okay. The good plan that's coming out in July of this next year has a $166 deductible, then it acts like an F the rest of the year. F is fabulous, so you won't have to do any more co-pays the rest of the year. We're going to look hard at this plan when it comes out in July. It basically comes down to mathematics. We're going to look at it and see if it makes sense. But in the meantime, it's coming. It's not here yet, so we'll get there when we get there. Coming in July and has a deductible. All right, let's move on to the Part D drug plans. Ladies and gentlemen, the standalone drug plans are getting out of control. The drugs in this country are getting out of control. The prices are getting out of control. I mean, we've got to do something about the price of the drugs and medicine in this country. It's just getting ridiculous. So we're going to have to look hard at this year. We got to look at the medicine because it's some of this stuff is just crazy. So the preferred plan with United Healthcare is going to $86. That's jumping from $68 to $86. Most of you in this room, I don't want you to freak out because your plan, remember your Advantage plan, has your drug plan built in automatically. So this $86 plan that people are with a supplement plan are paying on their own, it's going from $68 to $86. That's the jump. All right? They have the Saver plan. It was $31, it's going to $34.40. And they have a new plan coming out this year. It's called the Walgreens plan. Brand new plan coming out, United Healthcare, called the Walgreens plan, $22.50. All right.
Are these by the month?
These are per month. Per month, you're paying for that. So everybody that has a supplement plan has their standalone drug plan, their own, and every one of those people are going to get a call from our office because we got to look at it. We got to look at it hard this year because we got to make sure that preferred plan at $86 is ridiculous. All right? We've got to look at it and make sure that.
You had somebody that was asking about Silver Scripts too, and I didn't see that.
Got it, okay. So the Part D drug plans are getting up there. So the benefit of it, of the Part D for the preferred, it's $86, but it has a zero deductible. So day one, your generics are free, and there's no deductible. Price is going to $86. The Saver plan, remember that the one that's $31 going to $34? What's nice about that is, again, the generics are free, and it has a $400 deductible. So beyond your generics, you get the generics, tier ones and twos, but the brand name drugs, the first $400 is out of your pocket, and you have to keep making the $34 a month payment. The Walgreens plan, that's the new one they're just coming out with right now. It's a stripped down plan, $22 a month, no deductible if you get your generics, no deductible for the generics, but your brand name drugs, tier 3, 4, and 5, are $400. So Medicare sets that price, not United Healthcare. Medicare sets the price, and with the Walgreens plan, you have to use Walgreens or OptumRx, the mail order service. So you have to use one of those two in order to qualify for this Walgreens stripped-down plan. Okay, what you've all been waiting for. All you have the SHARP plan, plan four, all that. We're going to talk about that now. The Advantage plans. The Advantage plans, United Healthcare. They have five different plans. They have the SHARP plan that gets you to all your SHARP doctors and your Arch Health Partner doctors. The one was just here. The SHARP plan gets you to all the SHARP doctors, Arch Health Partner doctors. The plan four, the United Healthcare, both these plans, the SHARP plan and plan four, are zero premium plans. Cost you nothing monthly to have these plans. Both of these plans, plan four will get you to Scripps. It gets you to actually any of the 10 medical network doctors that they have with United Healthcare. You can go to SHARP, you can go to Scripps, Arch Health Partners, Cassie Medical Group, Tri-City, Mercy Physicians. I mean, they've got them all. But if you have SHARP doctors, Arch Health Partner doctors, you want to go with the SHARP plan, the benefits are a little bit better. The co-pays are a little bit better. Plan four gets you to the Scripps doctors. We have the Value Plan, Premier Plan, Essential Plan. So the difference with those are the Premier Plan is something that United Healthcare had 20 years ago in San Diego. So many that started out, I've been with United Healthcare from day one, well, you're probably on the Premier Plan. And I've done my darndest to go through everybody and get them off of it. I don't see the benefit. Premier plan. Joey, do you have the Premier plan?
Are you talking about Scripps now or SHARP?
I'm talking about Scripps right now. So the different, there's four different plans on your sheet. Remember that comparison sheet right here? Everybody got their comparison sheets out? Got it. So let's look at your comparison sheets because those are the ones, the different plans that are offered in San Diego for you guys, okay? Let's move on. The SHARP plan and the plan four, the first two plans on the left-hand side of your product overview sheet, those are zero premium plans. Those are the two plans we're going to focus on this year. Both of those plans will get you to any doctor in San Diego that we need to get to. So it's SHARP, it's Arch, it's Cassie Medical Group, it's Scripps. We can get to them. Now, both of these plans will get you that over-the-counter benefit where you get your $200 worth of over-the-counter medicine for free. But we have to be on one of these two plans going into this next year. So the SHARP plan, let's break it down. How many people are with SHARP? Good, most of you. So the SHARP plan remains a zero premium plan going into this next year for 2017. That means it costs you nothing to have this plan. It's just copays when you go to your doctor. The copays remain $10 to your primary doctor, $35 for a specialist. The max out of pocket, what that means is if you go through all your doctors and specialists and hospital and a lot of activity, you're in and out of the physical therapy, rehabilitation, gets expensive after a while. If you get to $3,400, you don't pay any more copays the rest of the year. It was $3,500, they lowered it to $3,400. That's a change this year, change.
That does not include prescriptions.
It does not include prescriptions. Prescriptions is a whole different animal. Okay. All right, hi Joy.
I have the SHARP plan.
Uh-huh. Correct. So that SHARP plan, it's the same as it was last year. So it's $260 a day. They pretty much do it by night. So if you spend the night.
I need to ask a question.
Sure.
I had two nuclear tests.
Okay.
I have a lot of other tests. Will I get a separate bill for those kinds of tests that are out of the ordinary?
Nuclear test, huh? Are you glowing in the dark? The answer is no. Whatever takes place while you're in the hospital is covered under that $260. So the anesthesiologist, the bed, the nurses, the doctors, the surgery, the bad food, all included, one price, $260. You're not going to get a bunch of different bills. All right, with that SHARP plan, zero premium plan, gets you to all your SHARP doctors and Arch Health Partner doctors. It has a $3,400 max out of pocket, $200 for the over-the-counter benefit this year, new this year, and also the free Silver Sneakers gym membership. How many of you guys are lifting weights every day, working out? All right, looking good. So you get that free gym membership, then you won't feel bad if you don't go because you're not paying for it. Yes?
Does it matter whether it's SHARP Re-Steely or SHARP?
Good question. The question is, does it matter if it's SHARP Re-Steely or SHARP Community or... The answer is no. Sharp is sharp is sharp.
Right.
Without getting too technical, Sharp has five different fingers. Sharp Re-Steely, Sharp Community, Sharp Inland, Sharp Graybill, and Arch. There's your five. I knew there was five in there somewhere.
What about the Sharp Secure Horizon?
Sharp Secure Horizon is this plan that we're talking about right now. That's it. Yep. So if your card... Your United Healthcare card has SHARP in big letters in the top right corner of the card. This is your plan. I recommend you stay on this plan going into 2017. Everything stayed the same. If only thing that changed, it made it better. They lowered the max out of pocket by $100 and they added the over-the-counter benefit. It's still zero premium. Copays are the same. They added a $200 over-the-counter. It's great. So I'd say we stay with it. Not Scripps with this particular plan. The next plan is what we're going to talk about is Scripps. The SHARP plan only gets you to SHARP doctors and Arch Health Partner doctors. This plan's only exclusive for those particular doctors. If there's a downside, that's it. Plan 4, it's the second one over on your comparison sheet. Plan 4. Plan 4 is a zero premium plan also. But look what happened. They added transportation. United Healthcare has never had transportation in their plans until this year. For those that need transportation, you now can have it on Plan 4. We're getting 24 round trips, 24 one-way trips, which is 12 round trips on this. You phone, call them up, say I need a ride. They generally want 24 hours, 48 hours ahead of time. They'll send a van, pick you up, take you there. Call them up when you're done, they come pick you up, take you back home again. So you get 12 round trips, 24 one-way trips. So if you have somebody to pick you up, or you had somebody to drop you off there, and they just call them and have them take you back home, Plan 4 is for you. Zero premium plan. What's nice about Plan 4 is you can get to any one of the 10 medical networks United Healthcare has. Whether it's Arch, Sharp, Scripps, you want Scripps, you want United Healthcare? Here's your plan, Plan 4. It's the second one over. In the middle of your books, you all have, middle of your tables, you have like little questionnaires. Can you grab me one of these right here? There you go, thank you. So we're going to be really efficient this year. And in the middle of your tables, you all have these little questionnaire things. My fabulous bride made these up. And what happens is, we've got about 140 people here today. Probably not going to get a chance to talk with every one of you. But if you fill this thing out, I promise you I will call you. I'm going to spend the next 7 weeks calling you and setting everything up. If we need to change, we need to move something, we need to look into something, fill this out, leave it in the middle of your table. We'll gather it afterwards, and I'll be in touch. If we need appointments, I'll come see you. If you want to come see me, I've got an office in Rancho Bernardo. We'll fill these out, and that's a good way for us to communicate, okay? So plan four. You want to go to Scripps, plan four is for you. New feature this year, transportation, and it has the over-the-counter benefit. Value plan. Value plan was a $25 plan. The value plan went to $22. They lowered it by $3. All right? The value plan also has the free generics. And let me back up and say all these plans we're talking about, tier ones and twos generics are free. The ones and twos generics are free. You had a quick question? Correct. So
they should all say zero, starting with a zero.
That's a good point that you brought up. So if you go to the local pharmacy and pick up your medicine at CVS, they're going to charge you for it. If you go through the mail order service, the 90-day mail order, OptumRx, that's where you get your generics for free. So they want you to use the mail order service, OptumRx. If you go to the local pharmacies, they're going to charge you. Quick question. Yep, so that value plan is going to be the third one over on your sheet. Third one over is a value plan. 125 went down to 22. I don't really see any benefit being on the value plan. It's been around for years. They should get rid of it. You had a quick question. I missed it. Say it again. Say it again. Good question. Does Plan 4 have a free gym membership? No, the answer is no. You have to pay for the gym membership this year, and it went to $18 for the silver sneakers. $18. So Plan 4 does not have the free gym membership. The only plan that has a free gym membership is the Sharp plan. All right. Pay for silver sneakers and the value in the Premier plan, the $69 plan. Does anybody have that $69 Premier plan? Let's have them call me. I don't see any benefit of it.
Jeff, is there any extra charge going from a Scripps plan to the Sharp plan that I'm on?
No.
Okay. Thank you.
No cost to change these plans. We can take care of it. You had a quick question.
Yeah. If on the plan four, you can only go to Sharp or Arch. What if you're out of town and you get sick?
Good question. Question is, if you're on plan four and you can only go to your primary doctor, your network, what happens if you go out of town and you get sick? Well, all of these plans have emergency services. So you can go to urgent care, emergency room, ambulance, worldwide. Emergency services. That's including the helicopter ride off the cruise ship. Right? Just had it happen. Some of these other plans are $5 cheaper. They charge you for it. That's a $20,000 ride. Right? So with this, you'll be able to get all your plans that we have here. It's considered an ambulance ride, that helicopter. Quick question, Marge.
I'm on the first plan.
Yep, Sharp plan. Yep.
I'm going on a cruise. Now, does that cover?
It does. Question is, if you're going on a cruise and you have the Sharp plan, is it covered? Yes. So you go to the local emergency on the ship, that would count. Sometimes they have you pay the bill, bring it back, and get reimbursed, all right?
Okay. And how about transfer off the ship?
Transfer off the ship, if you had to get helicoptered off, they're going to pick you up. They're not going to take you sightseeing. They're going to take you to the local hospital. They'll get you fixed up. Yes, it'll be covered and as an ambulance ride, $275. All right, so Premier plan, anybody on that $69 plan, they're lowering it by $3. Big deal. I don't see any benefit being on that plan. All right, so if we're gonna spend that kind of money, we're gonna go a different direction. Essential plan, any military guys here? My military guys, here we go. Essential plan does not come with drug coverage. So the essential plan does not have drug coverage, and it's nice thing about it, it's $50 per stay when you go to the hospital. But you have to have the Part D, so unless you're in the military, have VA benefits, this plan is not for you. But it's got some nice benefits, so I know you've got your husband's on it. You can go to the hospital every day. So when you kick your husband out of the house, you send him to the hospital because he can stay all month for $50. Many of you have read the newsletter that I put out every month. I sit down and I write it. I said, God, I hope they read it. So this month we had the news of the kiosk that came out. So there's certain parts of this that I kind of key on every month. One of them is the referrals, the referral part. And I appreciate more than you know your friends, your company, your people, and send them over to Bridalwood so we can take care of them. So I've tried to, even Joy Tarchin's right there. There's Joy, she's right there, there's Joy. And there's Priscilla, came too. So I appreciate very much the referrals you send, because it shows the trust that you've put in us, and we've worked hard to earn that trust from you. So I look at that every month, and I sure appreciate it. Personal notes. Anybody read the personal notes? So unfortunately, I've got family and kids and all kinds of stuff going on. So this is a chance for me to exercise my demons and put it out to you in the personal notes. So I'm glad that you read them. It kind of keeps me... So you know what's going on in my life, right? So that's kind of what we've done. But really, what's happened, though, is with Bridalwood, in this business, you get to a certain point where you have a number of customers that you have, and bless your heart, I love you guys. You get to about 500-600, and you start getting, the phones are ringing, you can't handle much more because you've got to take the time. Well, I got to about 1,200, and you guys are keeping me busy. But there was so much of a need out there for people that needed Medicare help that we had to do something different. So that's when we started Bridalwood Insurance. Because the answer came low, if I can handle 1,200 people, how do I handle 5,000? How do I handle 10,000? And the answer was simple. I can't do it by myself. So I started Bridalwood Insurance in May of 2014, so we're about 2.5 years old. And use the same philosophy that I use with you guys. Straight up, be honest, tell them like it is, take your arms around them and take good care of them, right? And so we've been putting that policy, that blueprint, and put that out there. And in the last 2.5 years, we've now added 162 agents. Wow. We are the fastest growing Medicare agency in Southern California. And this last month, we added it up, and we helped over 20,000 seniors this last month alone at the Bridalwood. Every day, that number is growing. So between our customers and our agents and our downline and the people reading the newsletter, 20,000 people a month we're helping out. And I can't wait to see what it's going to be like 2 years down the road. I want 50,000. I want 100,000. There's so many people that need a good, honest insurance agency to take care of them, and that's why we're just growing leaps and bounds. And I want to thank you because you stayed with me and gave me the opportunity to build this thing. Well, I'll take some questions. I want to get you guys out of here. Go ahead.
Just have one question.
Yeah, Marge.
Is it in the future for United Healthcare to pay for chiropractic of a Sharp and acupuncture?
Good question. The question is United Healthcare in the future going to pay for acupuncture and chiropractor? And the answer is probably no. The one plan, the essential plan, the one, the military plan that didn't come with drug coverage, that does have it, but all the other plans do not. So actually Medicare, interesting enough, does not cover acupuncture. They think it's voodoo medicine and they do not cover it. They will pay a chiropractor, but they only reimburse the chiropractor about $26. So many chiropractors go, I'd go broke on Medicare. I can't even accept that. All right, another question.
Is
Brian.
Yes. The beginning of the meeting, you...
Coming to you next. Go ahead.
The beginning of the meeting, you wanted to know whether this experiment, quote, unquote, that you were saying, whether it would be applicable for the weekend. Who agrees with me that it will be?
The experiment. Oh, yes, got you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, so we get to do this thing on Saturday, the aging expo. 10,000 people come out. They put you in a room. They put you in front of 500 people, and you go, okay, it's all yours. He's like, ooh. Okay, so we'll do the best we can. You had a question back here.
Does driving insurance do SCAN as opposed to plan 4? SCAN is a better plan than plan 4. I just want to know, does Bridalwood Insurance handle SCAN?
Yes.
You call me up,
and I've got SCAN plans all day long. Absolutely. You want SCAN, we'll do it. And SCAN does have some benefits. They have the free gym membership. They have lower co-pays. They don't have the over-the-counter, but that's fine. Question back here.
We got switched in the middle of the term over to Grayville.
Okay.
How do we get back into something else? I don't like Grayville.
Got it. So the question is, middle of the year, probably your doctor left. Your doctor left, and he went to Grayville, and he just brought you right along with over to Grayville, and you go, I hate Grayville. Get me out of here. All right, so the way out is we have to change your primary doctor. Here's how these plans work. Whoever your primary doctor is, that's the network you have to choose from. If your doctor chose to go to Grayville, the only way to get out of Grayville is change your primary doctor to a different doctor outside of Grayville, and that'll get you outside of them. Well, we got a list of doctors for you. Put that on my little sheet, and I'll send you the list of the doctors. We have all the arch doctors and sharp doctors. You're up in Escondido? Yeah, so there's all kinds of doctors up there. Another question.
Is Mercy considered sharp?
Mercy's considered Scripps. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, I sure appreciate you guys coming out. They keep me pretty busy, and it's so nice that you can come to me. So I can kind of do these kind of meetings. Like I said, I got to do these things all year long, and this is my favorite one because it's like family. I didn't even put a shirt and tie on for you today. I just said, you know what? My wife says, you got to have a tie on. I go, no, it's all family coming out. We're fine. We're good.
Right on.
We're good. Thank you, guys. Thank you for coming out.